Now, despite the fact that Intel is currently being consumed alive by Yutani Corp, I mean, Nvidia, sorry, they still seem to be putting up a pretty good fight, at least when it comes to their graphics card drivers. I watched a Hardware Unboxed video recently where Mr. Steve has uncovered some huge performance issues being fixed in recent Intel GPU drivers. And considering that I think that some of the games that I test regularly can use some driver overhead problems being fixed with the B580, I'm very excited to check it out. Although, my testing didn't go great initially. But before we get into that, today's video is sponsored by Be Quiet's new light and dark mount keyboards, which as a big knob enjoyer gets me very excited. But aside from the knob envy on the light mount, and the reversible numpad with display keys on the dark mount, the main selling point of Be Quiet's keyboards is how quiet they are. It's like typing on mechanical air, very nice. So if that lack of sound in a mechanical typing experience sounds good to you, grab yourself some Be Quiet keyboard action using the link down below. Now when it comes to the testing for today's video, I'm gonna benchmark the Intel B580 GPU in this little Amazon system I built recently. It's got a Ryzen 5 5500, 16 gigs of DDR4 running at 3200 megahertz, and some other goodies in there. And I think that this system is exactly the kind of PC which should benefit the most from these recent driver updates. Because Mr. Steve from Hardware Unboxed fame has discovered over strenuous benchmarking for the last year that Intel GPUs have a bit of a driver overhead problem with slower CPUs. I would definitely recommend checking out that video if you haven't seen it yet, but a rough outline of the problem is that the lower end you go in terms of CPU, the worse Intel GPUs compare to their stablemates from other companies. The example that Mr. Steve uses is comparing an RX 9060 XT 8GB to the B580. When you use a fast CPU like the 9800X3D, the performance delta between those two graphics cards isn't massive. But when you step down to a lower-end AMD CPU like the Ryzen 5 5600, there's a much bigger performance gap, which is something that Intel is in the process of fixing with their latest drivers. So with that, I'm gonna start off with the Intel B580 running in that Amazon system with older drivers, this version, to get a baseline reading, and then we'll take it from there. Now, as is always the case, we're starting off with CS2 at 1080p low settings. Now, CS2 is a game we're very interested in because the drivers that I tested before, CS2 was one of the games where the B580 kind of struggled the most compared to its competitors, especially at 1080p. So hopefully the drivers help it here. As you can see, we are getting, you know, about 180 to 240 frames per second, which is in line with what we got last time we tested this system. And you can tell that both our CPU and GPU utilization is very low, but like, specifically the GPU utilization, we're dropping into the 30%. That is crazy. It's not supposed to be that low. Even for CS2, a game that, unless it's running on an X3D CPU, basically doesn't do anything on the graphics card. Next, we're looking at Cyberpunk. Here, it's running at 1080p high settings, and the B580 is doing a really good job. It's hovering around 80-ish frames per second, depending on where we look. The frame time graph is really nice and stable, which is something that often isn't the case with Cyberpunk. Having said that, we aren't getting 100% GPU utilization here, so the B580 is hanging around 75%. I'm also curious to see what Doom the Dark Ages does, because it's a game that doesn't seem to be on the surface particularly CPU bound, because, well, there's always 100% GPU utilization. Yeah, see, so here we're getting just an easy 100% utilization. It's just pegged up there. Our CPU utilization is also not super high. So on the surface, again, like I said, it seems like some driver update like this shouldn't necessarily make that big a difference in a game like Doom the Dark Ages, but I'm curious. So we've got The Last of Us running at 1080p high settings. Here, it's already using more than 8 gigs of video memory. It's exciting. The game is very happy about what's happening here. Wow, our CPU utilization is super high, and we're getting pretty big spikes in lag time. Okay, lag time. we're getting pretty big spikes in frame time. It's not ruining the gaming experience, but you can feel the stutters. We are getting about 100% GPU utilization. It does drop down a bit every now and then, but yeah, all these games are kind of interacting with the graphics card differently, so it'll be very interesting to see what the driver changes does to this. Wow, it's crazy how jumping up to 1440p basically doesn't impact the frame rate, because this GPU is so unhappy at 1080p. And then finally, I want to have a look at Stalker 2. I did a previous run, but I had a serious case of capture card dying, an issue that I have a concerning amount of. I don't know. I have a real issue with capture cards dying on me. But anyway, we have about 50 frames per second. Now, this is in a town bit where there is a whole clump of NPCs, which is just curb stomping our CPU. Yeah, so this is a situation where I am very curious to see what the drivers are going to do to it. Because, quite frankly, I think we have more of a CPU issue here, just full stop. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see. And then with 1440p, you can see that our GPU utilization is consistently a lot higher. And it kind of looks like it's dealt with our slight stutter issue. I mean, there's still, you know, there's a little peak going on. But this is pretty good frame time delivery. At which point, I installed some new drivers, going with version 8132, fired up some Counter-Strike 2, and aside from some run-to-run variants, it didn't make a difference. Which is really upsetting to me. That was like the one game where I really wanted it to make a difference. I then moved over to Cyberpunk, which weirdly had lower 1% lows than it did with the old driver, at least at 1080p. Moving over to 1440p eliminated that variance for some reason. Doom the Dark Ages, on the other hand, was rock steady between the two driver versions, seeing no variance in performance, although it kind of made sense. It was already doing 100% GPU utilization, so I wasn't really expecting much here. Interestingly, with The Last of Us, the new drivers actually fixed some of that stuttering we were getting at 1080p, which was a big difference. That really helped the playability of that game at 1080p, although 1440p saw the same results again, like most of the other games here. And then finally, Stalker 2 also didn't do anything. The drivers performed exactly the same, which was a huge bummer to me. I was really hoping that some of these games were gonna see some gains with the new drivers. Now, at this point, I was starting to get a little bit suspicious. Why was I not getting more performance out of this system configuration with my Ryzen 5 5500? So I decided to download the exact same Spider-Man where Mr. Steve demonstrated some massive performance gains with the new drivers. And this was the first game to definitively show some improvement. It wasn't huge at 1080p, but the jump was bigger at 1440p. Now at this point, I was starting to get really worried about posting this video because Mr. Steve demonstrated massive performance gains using a Ryzen 5 5600 and the B580 with these new drivers. But I guess it makes sense that the 5500 didn't gain as much performance, because not only is it a lower clocked CPU than the 5600, it's also got half the L3 cache, which definitely can't help the gaming performance. And then there's the other issue of the 5500 only supporting PCIe Gen 3 as opposed to Gen 4. So I think these three issues means that even with the driver update, we're just running into CPU bottlenecks here, which the 5600 doesn't experience in Mr. Steve's video. Now, I didn't want to just leave all of this just like this, so I decided to see what happens when I dropped the little Intel B580 into an Intel based system. So I decided to test this whole setup again using an i5-13400. Now with the Intel setup, when it comes to Counter-Strike 2, I've actually got some pretty good news, because going from the old to the new drivers, we gain about 30 frames per second average, and this scales both at 1080p and 1440p. So the new drivers do help the B580 perform a little bit better at Counter-Strike 2, which is great, considering that that was one of the games where this graphics card was really lagging behind its stablemates. Now granted, this benefit only happens, I'm guessing, if your CPU supports PCIe Gen 4, which is an important consideration, but there are circumstances where it does help CS2 performance. Now, interestingly, with Cyberpunk, again, we didn't really see much performance differences, except for the 1% lows being lower at 1080p with the new drivers. It's a weird result, but that was also the case with the AMD system. Stalker 2, unfortunately, also didn't benefit from the new drivers, although it was running a lot better on the Intel system than it was on the AMD system in terms of 1% lows and stuff, so it didn't have the same problems we wanted fixing the first time around. And then finally, with Spider-Man, we got about a 20% performance uplift at both 1080p and 1440p with the new drivers. So with that, I guess it means that Intel GPU performance is slightly less full of crap at the moment, but in a very full of crap way, which is kind of funny. I like that. It's very consistent in its inconsistency, which is cool. And yeah, if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to the channel, maybe watch some more videos. The suggestion will pop up in a second. And until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.